Troyia Monay, back to y'all with another video. Today's video is super exciting. In today's video, I'm going to be giving you guys the tea as to how much inventory you should be starting out with. This is definitely a question that has been all up and through my inbox. Deep down in the comments, you guys have definitely been curious as to how many pieces of inventory should you start out with, how many styles, how many packs should you buy, and all of that good stuff. So it's definitely going to be covered in this video. So make sure you guys go ahead and stay tuned. Give this video a big thumbs up. Thank you guys so much for the support, y'all. We are past 20,000 subscribers, y'all. And I just want to give a big warm hug to you guys. Just a big thank you so much for all the love and all the support, y'all. There is a huge giveaway coming up next week. So make sure you guys go ahead and turn on those post notifications so you guys do not miss out on the giveaway, y'all. It is going to be huge. So this was actually supposed to be my 10,000 subscriber giveaway, but now that we are at 20, it'll be my 20,000 subscriber giveaway. So thank you guys so much. Make sure you guys go ahead and rate, comment, like, subscribe, all that good stuff. Turn on that notification bell so you're always notified when I upload a new video. Also, go ahead and follow her Hustle Academy. There's so many dope things coming up for March. I am doing a free webinar in the month of March. So make sure you guys go ahead and follow at her Hustle Academy. It will be live. So you guys do not want to go ahead and miss that as well. So yeah, we're just going to hop right on in. I'm going to stop rambling. But yeah, let's go ahead and hop right on in. How much inventory should you guys be going ahead and starting out with? All right, y'all. I retired the computer. We got notebook now. So I took down some really good notes for you guys. So first things first. First thing that you need to do before you go ahead and even, you know, think about going and purchasing inventory is figure out what type of boutique you are having. Are you having a luxury boutique, an attainable boutique, or a affordable boutique? So you definitely want to know this before you go ahead and start looking for inventory and how many pieces that you should go ahead and buy. So that way you know how many pieces you should go ahead and buy. So if you are having a luxury boutique, then of course the, you know, the amount dollars wise of inventory is going to be up. The prices of that inventory is going to be high. Whereas if you're having an affordable boutique, you are shopping for more so those affordable pieces, and then the price of that inventory will be low. So it's important to know luxury, attainable is going to be pretty much in the middle, and then affordable. So definitely go in knowing that. So that helps you a lot when it comes to knowing how many pieces to start off with. Next thing you guys need to do is, I always stress the importance of this, create a budget, y'all. You need to create a budget. This helps you figure out how much inventory you can afford. So no sense in going ahead and shopping for inventory if you don't even know how much inventory you can afford, right? So make sure you go in with a budget. Have a clear idea as to how much you can spend on inventory. Like I said, no reason for you to go in and not know how much you can even actually spend. So make sure you guys go ahead and do that. One thing I always recommend is starting out with no less than 5 pieces and no more than 10. And the reason that I say that is because when you start off with more than 10 pieces, things get crazy. Not only is that a lot of content that you have to capture when you're just starting out, that's a lot of inventory to keep track of. That's a lot of, you know, money spent. And the reason I suggest that you guys keep it smaller when you're just starting out is you want to collect that free data. And if you guys have booked a one-on-one coaching session with me, you know all about free data. No sense in going ahead and paying for data, paying for, you know, ads and different things like that when you can get data for free. See those things that, you know, are attracting your customers for free. So what I mean by this is you need to provide options. So let's say you want to start off with 5 pieces of inventory. You can start off with a jumpsuit, a 2-piece set, a dress, a top, and a bottom. And you want to go ahead and do that if you are starting out with 5 pieces. No more than 5 pieces, I'll say that, is because you want to collect that free data. So let's say launch day comes around and you sell out of all your dresses. That's indication to you knowing, okay, I need to go ahead and restock these dresses, or I need to find something similar. So that's free data, you know, letting you know what your customers are interested in. Definitely don't be afraid to know if it's in your brand. Go ahead and try out different colors. Usually black usually sells out first. So that's definitely a tip there. But try out some different colors if, you know, if it fits your brand aesthetic, different things like that. But I really recommend you guys getting a variety of different items. So that way, like I said, you can collect that free data and you can see, you know, what pieces work for you, what pieces don't work for you. So that's definitely important. A comfortable number that I would start off with is going to be 8. And the reason I say 8 is because you're able to collect, you're able to have more than one type of item. So let's say you start off with 8 pieces. You can do 2 jumpsuits, 2 two-piece sets, 2 dresses, a top and a bottom. Boom. You have your 8 pieces. You can also, you know, mix and match it if you're going to be adding accessories or if you're going to be adding handbags, shoes, different things like that. So definitely start off with a wide range of items so that way you can see what items are getting the most attention and what items your audience is gravitating to most frequently. Another thing I want to note here that I have written down is always have matching pieces if you can. So let's say you start off with 5 pieces. You want to make sure you have a top and a bottom. You don't ever want to sell a bottom by itself and you never want to sell a top by itself. You want to sell those 2 pieces of inventory together. So that way in the consumer's mind, it's like, okay, in order for me to achieve this look, I need to go ahead and I need to purchase both of these pieces of inventory together. So make sure you guys go ahead and do that when it comes to pairing up inventory and all of that good stuff, period. One thing that you guys do need to know for sure, if you guys have done any of my coaching classes, then you guys know, or coaching sessions rather, you guys know the importance of inventory flow, y'all. Inventory flow is super important. That's one of the things that I struggled up with when I first started my boutique is I lacked inventory flow. So this is super, super important. Let's say you go ahead on launch day, you launch 5 pieces of inventory. Everything sells out on launch day. Or for the most part, everything sold out. You probably got, you know, maybe 1 or 2 pieces left. What are you going to promote tomorrow? What are you going to promote the next couple days? You always need to have inventory in the background. And what I mean by this is, let's say you do go ahead and you start off with 5 pieces. When you are shopping for inventory, you need to actually order 8 or 9 pieces. At least have 3 or 4 pieces in your background at all times. You guys never know when you are going to actually sell out of all of your inventory. You have no idea, you know, the control of the influence of your brand. Let's say an influencer gets a hold of your brand. They share one of your pieces. You had no idea they shopped with you. They share one of your pieces. Everything on your site is sold out. You didn't purchase, you know, any additional inventory to, you know, have just in case, you know, when have to roll out. Your inventory flow is super, super important. If you sell out of everything on launch day, what are you going to promote the next day? That's potential money that you're missing out on. Those are dollars that you're missing out on. We don't want to leave no money on the table, okay? Period. So make sure you guys keep a good inventory flow. Always have items in your background. I always suggest having 3 or 4 at all times in your background. So as soon as you see things are selling out, that's as soon as you need to be ordering more inventory. Always have items in your cart, y'all. Literally on Fashion Go, I have a cart full of items for my relaunch. Have a cart full of items ready to go. So as soon as things are selling out, as soon as you're making your profit back and that revenue back, go ahead and, you know, buy that new inventory. You always want to have a consistent flow of inventory. And that's something that I messed up with when I first started my boutique, is I didn't expect to sell a lot of my pieces on launch day. I expected to, you know, maybe have 5-6 orders. Nah, launch day came around, I had about 20-30 plus orders. And you guys are definitely going to be the same way. You're gonna underestimate the value of your efforts. I know a lot of us do, but never do that. Always have inventory in the background that you can, you know, offer up really, really quickly. What else do I have on here? Yeah. That's pretty much everything, y'all. If you guys have any questions about how many items you guys should go ahead and start off with. Oh, another thing I wanted to mention was how many packs. Always start off with just 1 pack. That's it. Right now, when you guys are going ahead and you are starting, you are testing out the market. Period. You are testing it out. That's why I said always start off with a wide range of items as well. You're testing it out. You're seeing what works and you're seeing what doesn't work. So if you're sitting here and you're buying 5 or 6 packs of different, you know, items, and you sell out of one, if you sell one of them, at least you didn't buy 5 or 6 packs, you know. Always start off with 1 pack. Also, one thing I will say is if you have a large influence, let's say you haven't even launched yet, you have tons of people, you know, anticipating this launch. And when I mean tons of people, I mean you have an actual following. You have people who are anticipating you to launch this boutique. Then that's when I would say, okay, then you probably should start off with maybe 2 or 3 packs, because you have actual people, you have actual customers already. Whereas if you're just starting out and, you know, you have maybe a few hundred or maybe under 100 followers, you're not exactly sure, you know, what's going to sell out, what's not going to sell out, always start off with 1 pack. But yeah. That's pretty much my tidbit on how many inventory you guys should start off with, how many packs of inventory, and yeah. I hope this video was helpful. Make sure you guys go ahead and follow at her Hustle Academy. Stay tuned for that free webinar that is coming up. You guys, it is going to be lit. Thank you guys so much for over 20,000 subscribers. I love you guys. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video.